Hi buddies, hope you are doing fine. In this series we are going to see the introduction of Pindar, who belongs to the period of ancient literature. So if you are ready, let's get started. Pindar, who lives in the period between 522 BC to 443 BC, and he was born in the place of Zinocephale and died in the year around 438 BC in the place of Argos, which is situated in Greece. And he was an ancient Greek lyric poet from Thebes. He was the first Greek poet to reflect on the nature of poetry and on the poet's role, and his poetry often illustrates about the beliefs and also values of archaic Greece at the dawn of classical period. About 10 days before he died, the goddess Persephone, who appeared to him and complained that she was the only divinity to whom he never composed a rhyme. Goddess of Persephone, who is the daughter of Zeus and Demeter and wife of Hades, who was the king of the underworld. Pindar, who died around 440 BC while he attending a festival at Argos. Scholars at the Library of Alexandria, who collected Pindar's compositions in 17 books, which into organized according to genre. The very famous work of Pindar is his victory odes. The victory odes are grouped in 4 books. They are Olympian, Pythian, Isthmian, and the final one is Nemean Games. Now let's see the every books of Pindar. He wrote several books, like a book of hymnoi, that is about hymns, and a book of paints, and also he wrote 2 books of dithyrambi, that is dithyrambs, and he wrote 2 books of prosodia, which is about processionals, and he wrote 3 books of parthenia, that means a song for light dawns, and he wrote a book of threnoi, which means laments, and then he wrote 4 books of epinikia, which is about victory odes. And above all the every works of Pindar, his epinikia odes, which is very famous, and also it is a work to commemorate athletic victories, and it is the one and only work which is survive in complete form. In Pindaric ode, there are 3 types of stanza in each ode based on choral positions. The first type is strophe, which is right to left, and the another type is antistrophe, and it is a opposite of strophe, that means left to right. And the final type of Pindaric ode is epode, and it is in the form of a circle, and it is the choral position. Okay, and finally, in Pindaric ode, there may be a variation. So a variation of Pindaric ode, which is called irregular ode, and this kind of irregular ode was developed by the 17th century writer Abraham Cowley. And finally, Longinus, who is a philosopher who likes Pindar a lot, and Athenaeus, he was a Greek rhetorician and also a grammarian, and he is known for a public orator, and he belongs to 3rd century. He refers Pindar as a great orchid Pindar. So that's all about the introduction of Pindar and all about him. So hope this video will be useful one, and thank you so much for watching this video till end. If you are having any suggestion, let me know in the comment section. We'll see you next video. Tata, bye bye.